Andreas keeps his arm bent, see, and put his hands together. See, now I'm not teaching arm, but right now I'm teaching control in the, well, we call this position the grapevine, if you can select, or whatever you call it. But now I'm actually teaching control there and how to break the grip, and then I teach arm bar, right? So we take the complication away by not doing any grip breaks. So it goes over this arm alone, right? And now Andreas is gonna defend with his arm alone, okay? So and always attack and defense go a bit together. Obviously, you have to give something that you can defend. So right now at the beginning, Andreas, I want you to do this. I want you to bend your wrist, see? And bend your bicep as tight as you can. And I'm just gonna, like, with mediocre technique, I'm gonna try to pull your arm away, okay? You don't have to grab anything, just keep it here. So give me a chance, yeah? So keep, bend your wrist, please, see? And I'm gonna pull backwards. Resist, eh? No bridging, just the arm. And so on. Was it hard or no?
A bit.
Sorry?
A bit.
Yeah. Did your biceps get tired?
A bit.
Yeah. Why is this? Because this is like doing a biceps curl against my whole body. Now, it was not easy. I could not just break it. I need to actually better techniques how to do this. So for example, if he bends, see, instead of pulling backwards, easier would be if I go sideways, then peel it open or go to the other side. So Americana or Kimura side, right? But in any case, see, what I just want to prove is that just bending and trying to biceps curl yourself through it is not an easy thing to do. So now we're gonna do the next phase. Look, Andreas in the previous phase, bend his wrist and bend his elbow. So now what I want to do with him now is instead of bending the wrist, I want to still make a fist, see, but like extend your wrist. Keep it in the middle, please. Here, extend your wrist like that. And now I'm going to do the exact same thing. Okay. And eventually I will win. But did you feel a difference?
This is harder to hold.
This is hard to hold for you. Yeah. That doesn't make sense. But doesn't worry. So we'll not cut it. We keep it. Normally this should be easier, but no worries, we're not there yet, it will be the next step. So I want to test this out, I want to feel a difference at home, what is the difference between bending the wrist and pulling and extending the wrist. So one more time, and be honest, we're going to try it again. If it's still harder, then it is harder, and that's fair. So be honest, it is harder,
yeah.
Okay, no worries. So keep the wrist bent, see, because it's not the next step. Now I want you, instead of bending the wrist alone, I want you to make to open your hands and make a claw. So bend your fingers. So make like really a super tight claw. Super tight. Okay, good. And overextend your hand a bit more. But make a claw. So bend your fingers like as if you grab something like this. But keep your fingers open. Yeah. So here, and keep it super tight. And overextend your wrist far. So like this. And now I'm gonna feel it again, okay? Easier or harder?
Easier.
This is easier. So normally the middle step should also be easier. So, but Andreas is weird, okay? So that's okay. But in any case, so try. The first one, you keep hand bent and the biceps bent. And it's really try the muscle and keep it tight. The second thing, you try to do the same thing, but with the fist extended. And then you make a claw. Now, in reality, do it please. If it was really on the street, I would agree this is not a good thing because they can just start peeling your fingers. But since this is not allowed in Jiu-Jitsu, we cannot pull fingers. We can play with these things, right? So this is okay. Now for some reason, and I will go try to explain it why. See, if you make your hand like that and you put it on bent, it changes the muscle engagement. You can even start playing with different fingers and you feel like the muscle twitching are working different in your elbow. It's just muscle engagement and that changes how the biceps works. Now the third step right now, like the previously, you try to actively bend your arm, right? Okay, look. So if I'm here and I'm pulling and you try actively to bend your arm again to bring it back. So now Andreas is using biceps and chest muscle. But he's trying to pull my whole weight closing, which is very, very hard and tiring. And that's what makes your arm sore. If think about this, when I roll, I rarely have ever gas for, I rarely ever gas to begin with. But in the past, if I got tired, it was rarely because I guessed. It was mostly because your arms get very tired. Imagine holding a double under or try to pull that arm, or try to defend that arm, it's because your arms get tired. That's the first thing always gets tired. That's the arms. And the core and the legs less. Yeah? But if you try to defend and curl with your biceps against someone's whole body weight, then it makes sense your biceps will get tired. And also I've seen people who rip off part of their chest, because if you pull in and I pull this way, this is a recipe for disaster. So don't do that. Instead, try to bend it, try to bring it back, just try to keep it where it is. So if I'm here, keep it tight, see? And it makes more of a claw. So look, so now you're doing this, you have to try to overextend the fingers as well. So not just this, but like, that's it. Make a claw, and yeah. So this instead of this. I hope you can see it on camera. So here, but, okay. It's not too much important, it's all a feeling in the end. So now instead of, and that's when I pull, instead of trying to bend your hand, see? I'm going to push on the elbow. And I'm going to try to bring it away, okay? Just keep it in the center. Don't try to bridge. And if it happens, it happens, okay? Try to put pressure on the elbow. If I go straight backwards, I cannot get it with me. What I can do, though, is go sideways as I bring the arm with me. That's a possibility. And then maybe I can take it back. But in this angle, it's very hard to do so. Was this tiring for you?
Less so,
okay, so good. So I want it to make it zero tiring, to just keep the pressure, and then you go with me, and we're gonna go complete to the end, I'm gonna see if I can finish it in the middle, okay? So keep tight, do the same thing, try to slow the process, see, you can even extend your arm a little bit more, see? And just try to, so it's not a problem if your elbow goes with me. It is a problem if the hand goes with me, because then that's when I can break it. So don't try to forcefully pull it back, just, try to slow the process without getting tired. That's the best way I can describe it. Okay, here. So put more pressure on my hand. Yeah, that's it. And that's it. I'm gonna go with me. Look, and even if, see, so like the elbow a little bit, okay? Even when I get completely to the edge, see, so at some point, look, once we get past the center, see now, so the elbow, this is 90 degrees. As long as we are below 90 degrees, I have to keep my elbow inside his elbow. Once this hand passes the 90 degrees, that's when I can slip up to go to the hand. You need this to bring about to use maximum leverage. As long as I keep pulling in the elbow, I might extend the chest, but I'm not going to extend his arm, see? But if I get it like a little bit higher, see, and I slide up, so bend your arm, please. See, now if I start sliding here, he can actually bring his arm out, see? I'll pull the elbow in, and then it will slip out. But if I slowly go with me, see here, go bring it with me and go sideways a bit, see? And I can slide towards, and once it's past 90 degrees, I can slide my hand up and take it with me. So now we go to the edge again, see? And relax a bit more and freeze. So now again, put pressure on your hand backwards, see? Make your claw, and now put a lot of pressure on your left, so your elbow, please, on this elbow. Yeah. And I'm gonna try to armbar you from the center. So no more rolling, just stay here. Because you did great actually, but this is the next step. So keep the wrist bent. I'm gonna put pressure straight down. Very hard. I'm gonna put more pressure here. Ah, turn your hand, so it taps, huh? Turn your hand more. See, keep rotating your hand this way, please. I'm gonna keep pushing the other side. See, so towards the camera, see? I'm gonna lift my hip up. Keep tight on your elbow, put pressure on your elbow, please. Rotate more the hand. Nah, you shouldn't tap for this. So try turn more, see, and put pressure on the elbow, okay, like this. So like you give yourself the Americana. Yeah. So now I'm gonna put my hip as high as I can, and keep reaching if you can. Exactly. There is a limit to it, but it's very hard for me to finish this. What is the limit? Because he's not rotating right now, right? So this is the first part of this. I will do the same part in this video, but what I meant, you first teach this. See, and see how far I can take it. And I call this the mannequin arm. So this helps for Americana, Kimura, and you can get up. See, armbar, so for armbar, Kimura, and omoplata, all those things. So what I do, look, is like this, you lift your hand up, one, elbow, shoulder. See, and now my arm is like a mannequin, see? I can move my body, see? Then my arm stays where it is. I can roll my arm as a whole. Whereas if I start stretching, that's when I get finished.